Hey, and welcome to this short introduction to advanced blocking with uBlock Origin. If you're unfamiliar, uBlock Origin is a lightweight but powerful blocking extension, mostly used against ads available for all major web browsers. If you have used the extension before, you probably clicked on the big blue power switch to block or whitelist a website. For users who want more control of what to block, there's an advanced user mode. Maybe you have seen it before in the settings. To reach the settings, click on the little gear icon in the top left corner. Check, I am an advanced user. Don't let this warning scare you. Give it a read, but if you used extensions like NoScript before, this won't be much more difficult. As you can see, uBlock Origin now enabled an advanced table to finally control what to block. This is what is called dynamic filtering. The filter lists you used before are called static filtering. Let me explain how it works. There are two main columns you can click with three small columns each. The main column on the left applies every change globally, meaning all websites. The main column on the right applies locally, to the current website only. Each one of the three small columns has a different color: green, gray, and red. Green means allow this type of content always, regardless of filter lists. Gray means don't do any dynamic filtering but still apply static filter lists. This would be the same result as not using dynamic filtering at all. Red means never allow this type of content, regardless of filter lists. Now each row has a different type of content to filter. All requests, this applies to all the listed types of requests below. Images filters all images. Third party filters every request from third party websites. Inline scripts filters all scripts embedded in the main document of the website. First party scripts filters all external scripts pulled from the same domain of the current website. Third-party scripts filters all external scripts pulled from different domains than that of the current one. Third-party frames filters all frame elements pulled from a different domain than that of the current web page. YouTube videos on other websites are often embedded through frames, for example. Below that are the different top-level domains from content present on the current web page. This allows filtering of specific domains. If you click the plus icon next to all, it also shows subdomains for even more precise control. The plus and minus icons next to the domain names are indicators for content already being allowed or blocked. Both in the same row mean some content was allowed and some was blocked. If you change anything about the dynamic filtering, you need to reload the web page for it to take effect. You will also see two icons in the top left, an eraser and a lock. This is because dynamic filtering can sometimes be a trial and error process. Click the lock to make your previous changes permanent, or click the eraser to revert the changes. You can also change these dynamic filter rules in a list. Go to the uBlock Origin settings and click on the My Rules tab. Go to Temporary Rules and click Edit. Here's how this works. First, type in the source domain, for example facebook.com. Now this rule will only apply to facebook.com. Instead, you could also type an asterisk to make it apply everywhere. Second, type the destination domain. This is the domain you want to block or allow, for example youtube.com. This filters every occurrence of youtube.com on facebook.com. Third, type the type of request this should apply to. This has the same options as the interface, like images, third-party scripts, or third-party frames. And fourth, type in the action, allow, noob, or block. In the interface, allow is the green bar, noob is gray, and block is red. Again, this list does the same thing as the user interface, but is easy to copy and export to a file. I hope you like this introduction to advanced filtering with uBlock Origin. feel free to post questions in the comments.